Path of Exile ramps up and counts down to its next expansion. APB Reloaded introduces a top-notch anti-hack system. Area Games tries on a MOBA for size, and Rusty Hearts is counting down its last days. What's happening, guys? James Blonde here with MMOHuts.com with a quick weekly recap for MMO news and announcements for the week ending August 4th, 2014. And our first bit of news this past week is about a brand new content update for ZMR called Mummy Sea, Mummy Doom. In this update, whole cities in China and Egypt have been overtaken and transformed into nightmarish versions of the ancient worlds, teeming with hordes of undead horrors. I was wondering when we see the giant mummy boss that we've seen in some of the earlier trailers, and now here he is. The new content includes 6 new maps spanning across all various game modes, both PvE and PvP, also including more guns and more gear. Go figure. These new maps look to offer more in terms of traps and implements of death, including Egyptian-themed weapons that probably give you a damage bonus for using them in certain game modes and maps. Looks like a pretty fun update. I'm surprised, though, they haven't announced an official launch date for the game. Last week, Infernum's Hazard Ops announced that it would officially release on August 26th. It just introduced the Welcome to the Jungle update as well, leading up to launch. Next up, Reloaded Games announced the launch of Release 17 for APB Reloaded last week. The Open Conflict update, as they're calling it, introduces a revolutionary anti-cheat solution called Fair Fight. A new open conflict game mode, new matchmaking options, and several general game enhancements. Fair Fight, however, is the same server-sided anti-cheating system that protects other high-end games like Titanfall and Battlefield. It actually publicly broadcasts and shames every hacker it bans in real time. It's pretty legit. The Open Conflict system is a new matchmaking mode that means quicker matchup that selects your opponent based on availability rather than skill, leading to more entertaining and unexpected firefights than we've seen in the past. So, it's a pretty decent upgrade to APB Reloaded. Okay, so I've mentioned this a few times already, but last week we saw the launch of FireFall on Steam. And finally, after several years of forever beta, anyone and everyone can play FireFall Complete now with plenty of stuff to do. You've got campaign-style missions complete with impressive voiced narration, plus they vary and get you introduced into other things that you'll be doing in the game later on. And now that the game is launched, the dev team has simplified the battle frame system, crafting, and resource system. Not to mention, the AI is much faster and more challenging. So if you haven't ever played Firefall, or at least it's been a while, I'd say give it a shot now that it's been revamped for launch. It's a huge difference. Also available now, free-to-play on Steam, is Wakfu. Well, the closed beta anyway. The developers are wanting a fresh new feeling launch for the game now that it recently went free to play. So once again, the game has slipped into closed beta and players do actually need a key in order to get in. In fact, we had 1,000 keys on our giveaway go within a matter of minutes. Don't worry, there are plenty of sites giving out keys, including the Wakfu landing page itself. And I would say, seeing that there probably isn't much needed changed in the game for the transition, it shouldn't be that long before we actually see major public access. Next up, Blackhold Online is now in its second month of open beta, and Snail Games has a few peeks at what's to come for the game in the coming months. In the first major update planned for this fall, the level cap is set to be raised to 45, with new quests, activities, and a new tier of skill upgrades to match. An expanded arsenal of gear with new T3 equipment types is to come, cross-server PvP function for arenas and battlefields, new world maps, new instances, new dungeons, and battlefields are also planned, along with plenty of balancing and optimization improvements across the board. I would expect to see the game in a much more launched state after this new fall update. Well, you guys have been wanting as much up-to-date info on Skyforge as possible, and my.com released more info on content this past week, giving us an idea of what players will have access to from the start, and more about the unique class system in the game. In Skyforge, players will have constant access to all classes without the need to progress each class individually. The classes are actually divided into several groups depending on access level. Beginners have access to 3 classes at the start of the game, the Lightbinder, the Paladin, and of course the Cryomancer, which you see here. After completing various adventures and receiving rewards, intermediate and advanced classes with 5 in each become accessible. So various classes have various levels of access, but once you've unlocked them, you have unlimited access to them at any time, without having to level them up individually. This seems like a really cool setup, but what if the 3 starting classes are not any that you want to start with? I guess there really isn't a way around that. but that doesn't make me any less excited for the game. Also in my.com news, Armored Warfare dropped the teaser for the game's official soundtrack, which you guys have been listening to since the beginning of the Skyforge segment. According to the Armored Warfare press release, music is an integral part of a game, and it builds an atmosphere that really adds to the gameplay and immerses you into the battle. It's pretty cool, honestly. I'd say it even works nicely with Skyforge. But speaking of previews, Square Enix introduced a new trial program for Final Fantasy XIV, A Realm Reborn. What does this mean for someone looking for a free-to-play game? Well, not much, but it does give you a 14-day free trial before making any commitments. With some limitations, of course. Like a max level cap of 20 and a few limitations on available in-game activities. Either way, if you've been wanting to check out the game without making the leap, head over to the MMOHuts site post from the link below to pick up the link to download the trial. And hopefully it's a cure to your curiosity. It was just recently announced that Rise of Incarnates is hosting an open beta event starting this Friday, August 8th through the 17th. And it's available to all Steam users according to their announcement, so check the link below to their official homepage to sign up and be registered for access this Friday. Next up, a new Trove Talk was recently released for the end of July, this time highlighting user-created dungeons, a new Dragonfire Peak biome, home of the Dracolite, which is the community-voted player class set to release in a couple of weeks. The Dragonfire Peaks offer that traditional lava zone area look, and the layers also fit the theme, of course. We also get to see a new Shadow Invasion that spawns randomly and seems to offer various difficulties, but always drops good loot to upgrade your weapons with. And this past month, they've also introduced a pretty cool-looking new mount called a Pony Mount. It looks more like a dinosaur than a horse, if you ask me. Cool either way. Killer Combo released a new video last week showing off the Nature's Forces update to Rena's attack system in Elsword. So apparently Rena is going all natural. But by harnessing the power of the natural world, Rena has the capability of enhancing her basic attacks and various skills. Rena now has a Nature Force gauge that consists of 5 segments that charge individually when Rena makes 6 hits using basic commands. The more the bar fills, the more orbs you see around Rena, and the more damage is done when a skill that uses Nature Force is activated. Sad news for some Dungeon Crawler fans this past week, Perfect World Entertainment announced that it'll be shutting down Rusty Hearts this coming September. The game has been in service for 3 years now, and only as of the past few months have we not seen any new updates. So as of now, Rusty Hearts will no longer be available for download, and existing players will still be able to play until, of course, the official close date on September 15th. I can say, if a game like this is popular enough, it may eventually get picked up by another company down the road. We seem to see that more and more now, to be honest. If you haven't noticed lately, Path of Exile is working up to its next mini-expansion called Forsaken Masters. They've been slowly revealing more and more content as we get closer to the release date. The new expansion will introduce new and meaningful content based around the Forsaken Masters of Ryklast, whom are 7 men and women, masters of their trade, who were exiled by Dominus. As the title suggests, players will cross paths with these masters, each offering separate and unique quests, training, mission variations, item crafting and mod options, secret and customizable towns known as hideouts, and of course, new challenge leagues to follow. There's plenty to read up on and more to be released about the new expansion, so head over to the MMOHuts site post for even more details. Next up, it looks like Area Games is trying its hand at the MOBA genre. Yep, that's right, a new MOBA. And according to Area Games, this one is brimming with unique features and an extensive list of powerful, one-of-a-kind heroes. It's called Chaos Heroes Online, and once again, according to the press release, in this game, players can surprise their opponents by gearing up and re-equipping in the heat of battle without any need to go back to home base. Players can stock up on armor, potions, and weapons at any point on the way to destroying their opponent's base. Other than that, there isn't really much in terms of innovative details, unless you count the fact that players won't know who has won until the very end of the match. Not really sure what they mean by that. Like, you can't see the score, or it doesn't indicate your base is being destroyed even on the minimap? I don't know. Either way, Area Games has opened up a teaser site for the game, and you can sign up for the beta coming later on this fall. And finally, for our last bit of news, with SOE Live basically a week away, the Landmark team released a new building blocks video showcasing the use of water as a way to build. If you don't just want to explore the oceans, you could build your own island home, or even a Pirate Cove. The cool thing now is that you can work with water voxels, and soon we'll see lakes, rivers, and plenty of dynamic water sources in use. I'm actually hoping to find out a lot more at SOE Live. But anyway, guys, that's about it for all the MMO news and announcements for this week. If you're looking for more info on the news featured in the recap, check the links in the description below or head over to MMOHuts.com/news for even more MMO news. Feel free to discuss the news in the comments below or head over to MMOHuts.com/forums. But until next time, guys, that's going to be it for me. I'm James Blonde. See you out there, gamers.